बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। टुडे वी विल लर्न हाउ टू यूज सी ब्लॉक इन पीसीएम सॉफ्टवेयर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इज सी ब्लॉक एंड व्हाट्स इट्स पर्पस। सी ब्लॉक इज अ मॉड्यूल इन पीसीएम सॉफ्टवेयर व्हिच यू कैन यूज टू राइट योर कंट्रोल लॉजिक इन सी लैंग्वेज। इट इज अ फंक्शनैलिटी और मॉड्यूल प्रोवाइडेड बाय द पीसीएम सॉफ्टवेयर which you can use to replace all of your control blocks with the one simple block which is called C block. Now we will go towards how to add this block in our schematic. For this purpose, open library browser in the PCM software. Then under the elements section, go to the others subsection. Then open the function blocks. Here at the end of the function blocks, you can find the C block. Just drag and drop it on the grid. You can also search in the search bar of the library browser to find the C block. This is our C block. Just double click it to open the programming interface. Here on the top of it, you can name our C block. For example, I will name it as C block. If you check this checkbox, this name will appear at the top of the block. Then there is a section of inputs and output ports. In this section, you can define the number of inputs and outputs of the C block. For this tutorial, I will define two inputs and one output. Then in the coding section, there are four further sections. The first section is called variable or function definitions. In this section, you can include all the libraries and define all the variables which are required for your program. Here I will create three variables of type double. I will use variables A and B as the inputs and the variable Z as the output. Now the next section is called open same user function. In this function, you can initialize your variables. This function runs only one time at the start of the simulation. I will initialize all my variables to zero. Then there is a third section which is called run sim user function. This function runs at each time step of the simulation. This function has some default inputs. T is the simulation time. Delta is the time step of the simulation. Star in is the pointer which points to the input array. The size of this input array depends on the number of inputs the user has defined. Here I have defined two inputs, therefore this input array will have two elements or will be of size 2. Then there is a pointer star out which points to the output array. Here we have only one output, therefore this array will only have one element in it. Then there is an error pointer and error message pointer. In this window, I will write my code which will execute at each time step of the simulation. I will save inputs of the C block to the variables A and B. and then perform a simple function of addition and store the result in the variable z, and then pass that result to the output variable. So here is the code. As you know, the array in C language starts at the 0th index. Therefore, our first input is present at in 0 and second input is present at in 1. Note our sum, which is stored in variable z, is passed to the output array, which has only one element in this case. If there are multiple elements in the output array, then you have to pass something in all the elements before executing your code. The next section is the closeSim user function. This function is executed at the end of the simulation. The user can use this function to deinitialize or destroy the pointers. I will leave this function empty. At the end of this C block, there are two buttons. One is edit image, which has no use for the beginners. And the second button is called the check code. If you click this button, PSim will tell you whether your code has errors or not. Now this is showing us compilation successful, which means that our code has no errors. So I will click OK and close the window. Now the programming part of CBlog is done. Now it's time to give the inputs to the CBlog. For this purpose, I will add two constant blocks here as the input to the C blocks. So open the library browser. Here search in the find bar for constant block. This is our constant block. Drop it on the grid. I will set the value of first constant as 10 and the second constant as 5. Now the output should be 15. If I run my simulation like this, it will not run because C block requires something as a load. So as a formality, I will connect a resistor of any value at the output of the C block. You can choose any value of this resistance. You can also connect any other load, for example LED as the load. Now to display our output, I will use voltage probe and connect it on this terminal. I will name it as Z, as our output variable is Z. Now I will add simulation control in my schematic. and we will run the simulation for 10 milliseconds. Now it's time to run the simulation. This is a graph of our output, and as you can see, the value of z is 15, which is a sum of first constant and second constant, that is 10 and 5. So this means that our C code is running perfectly. In place of these constants, you can take these inputs from the sensors and pass the output of the C block to the switch of your circuit. So this was the tutorial of the C block. If you have any queries, then you can ask in comments. If you liked this video, then please hit the like button and please subscribe our channel.